Okay, so hello, hi, and very good evening to all those who are connected here with me. I am Prashil Badavaik. I am a chemical engineering graduate from VNIT and currently working with Godrej Industries. So here all we are preparing for GATE in a very splendid manner, and right now I am teaching chemical reaction engineering to the students connected here. So kal humne shuru kiya tha with your non-ideal CRE, that is your non-ideal reactor portion. Okay, so I'll quickly recap in yesterday's class what we studied. So ideal reactors, you know what is ideal reactors, and the one which are not following your assumptions, one which are not following your design or performance equations of ideal reactor, that is considered as your non-ideal reactor. Then we started different kind of conditions for non-ideality. Jahan pe dekha tha MFR, we have seen bypassing was there, then there was dead zone, then recirculation and all. Okay, in case of PFR, there were some particular types, that is one is channeling, then axial mixing is not equal to zero, and your radial mixing is not 100%. So these were common, but there was dead zone, there was recirculation on all. Okay, then we saw what is your RTD, that is your residence time distributions, where we are putting a small quantity, or depending on your type of injection, you are putting different amount of tracer, and tracer has similar property as your reaction mixture, but it is non-reactive, right? It is non-reactive, it is non-sticky, and property we saw. Then we have seen different types of injections. Jahan pe first one was your pulse injection, then second was step injection. So pulse mein kya hota, a small quantity of tracer we are adding at start at time t is equal to zero. Before that there was no tracer, right? So at time t is equal to zero, what kind of input you are getting? That is a sharp peak at t is equal to zero. Then in step manner, at time t is equal to zero, suddenly we are starting the putting of this tracer, and that is same over the period of time. Okay, that was your step injection. Okay, then we did the analysis for your pulse tracer injection, jahan pe humne padha tha what is your fraction of total tracer is coming at the exit. So first one was your, we are measuring your concentration of tracer at the exit of reactor as a function of time. So we got some kind of curve like I mentioned here, right? From this curve, we collected the data, what is your area under the curve. So what was that area under the curve? It was giving you what is total amount of tracer that has injected, okay? Like, it is not exactly that value, but it is proportional to that. Okay, whenever you are calculating this total value, total area, so that is your total tracer injected at time t is equal to zero. Then we found out what is your fraction of material that is coming between time t and t plus dt. So basically it was fraction coming in the range dt. Okay, so that was your what, et into dt, right? Et into dt. And we mathematically proved what is that exact value. Okay, so this is your et into dt, and we integrated it over the zero to infinite time, and we calculated the value. So we covered, so till we covered what is your fraction that is coming in dt, then we have defined one curve, that is ct curve, and second is your et curve. So it is your exit edge distribution function, right? Now, so your area under the curve was, what was that value? Your area under the curve, anyone? That is your n naught divided by your nu naught is your area under ct curve, right? So I told you this is giving you what is your amount of tracer that has been injected, kind of similar to that. Okay, so this was your value, and uske baad what is your fraction that is coming between time t and t plus dt. So that was your, this was your fraction, and that we calculated as concentration at time t, volumetric flow rate, this is giving you moles per unit time, and when you multiply it by time interval, you will get total moles coming in that range divided by what is your total injected, total tracer injected. So this was your fraction. Now tumhe pata hai, if I am integrating this fraction over time 0 to infinite, so what will I get? That is your fraction ka total value kya hoga, what is your maximum value of your fraction? 1, right? So whenever I'm integrating from 0 to infinite, dn divided by n naught, which is basically your integration of your ct nu naught dt divided by your n naught, 0 to infinite. And you know what is this? This is your ET, I told you, excited distribution function. I'll tell you what is this, its physical significance here. 0 to infinite into your dt, and this value is your 1, right? This value is your 1. Okay, yahan tak hum pahunche the. Now suppose if I'm plotting graph between your ET versus T. CT to pata tha tumhe. I'll tell you how to calculate ET from your CT, C curve or E curve, and this is your time. Okay, so suppose if this is a kind of this curve or this is your E curve, so what is area under E curve? What is your area under the E curve? What is that value?
1,
right? So please remember, this is very important concept while solving any question. Area under the E curve is always equals 1, because it is telling you what is your fraction of material coming, right? Fraction of material, and usko integrate karenge. If you integrate it, so we'll get total fraction. The total fraction value maximum 1 rehte. So this area is basically your area under E curve, and that is equals to your 1. Yahan tak hum pahunche the. Okay, now what is your ET? Can you please explain me, any one of you? ET is this value. What it represents actually? Right? Anyone? Would you like to tell something?
Exit phase distribution function.
Yes, that is the name of it. It is your exit edge distribution function.
And E of T into DT says fraction of material between T and DT.
Okay, so what is your ET then? That is fraction per unit
time.
Right, per unit time, kitna fraction aa raha hai. Right, so this exit edge distribution function is basically, so first I'll write this definition. This is your fraction of material, or fraction of material tracer you can say, between time t and t plus dt. Right, tumhara time interval kya hua? Dt. So this is your time interval. So what is this? This is your exit distribution function, that is your fraction of material per unit time. Unit time mein kitna fraction aa raha hai? Per unit time, what is your fraction value, right? So per unit time, what fraction of tracer is coming out? So you just multiply by time, you will get total value, right? Total time se multiply karoge to you will get total fraction, and that is equals to 1. I hope you are clear with this exit edge distribution function. Then what is your relation between E curve and C curve? Right, relation between E curve and your C curve.
It's a straight line.
Okay, yeah, it is directly proportional. There will be some multiplying factor there. So your ET is, by the way, CT nu naught divided by n naught, right? This is showing you ET is your directly proportional to your CT. Okay, then your ET, you can write it as CT divided by n naught divided by nu naught. Can you write? Right, okay. Then now whenever we calculated your area under C curve, what was that value, area under the C curve? Here, that is your n naught divided by nu naught. So can I replace this n naught divided by nu naught by your area under C curve? I can. So I can write here as CT. What is this CT? Anyone?
CT DT, integration of CT.
Yeah, that is okay. What is your CT, by the way? CT is your
concentration
of tracer at time T at your exit of reactor, right? At your exit of your reactor. That's why, what is its name?
Exit
H distribution function, right? There are functions which are also called as your exit ka, like I'll tell you that are some different that are H distribution function. So, but in this syllabus, your CRE2, we are dealing with exit H distribution, or there are some other values that represent your intermediate distribution function or some other. Okay. But for timing, you remember this only, and this is very important. ET. So, apne points cover ho gaye. Like you know what is your area under the C curve, you know what is your area under E curve. Now, yahan se abhi, suppose if I am giving you C curve, can you convert that C curve into your E curve? Can you convert that? Wait, there is charging problem in my laptop. I'll connect. Till that, how can you convert your C curve into E curve? The formula for same is given, okay? Just try to use that. Hello?
Sir, first we will calculate the area under CT versus CT. Yes.
Exactly. Suppose I'm giving you an example. We'll take one example. Right, this is your 0.5, this is your 1, this is your 1.5. Okay, this is your 1, this is your 2, this is your 3, and time is given in some unit. Let's say it is mole, or it is in minute, and here concentration is your moles per liter. Moles per liter. So this is your unit, and your curve is like this. Are you getting this curve? This is increasing up to value 1 and then decreasing, and it is 0. Can you please convert this C curve into your E curve? Simplest one I could draw. Please calculate your area under C curve first. How can you calculate area under the C curve? That is your area of
triangle.
Triangle.
So it's same. A graph will be same.
So you will get what is your area half into base into height, right?
Yeah.
1, right? So if you divide this concentration values by 1, so you will get E curve, right? So you divide your concentration by 1. So this is your E curve as a function of time. Okay. Then if you divide this 1 by 1, you will get same function, right? Same curve. 1, 2, 3. Here. Suppose if it is your, if your area under the curve is 2, then
we can divide the whole y-axis by 2.
Right? So we need to divide y-axis, each and every coordinate on y-axis by 2. So you will get e core, right? And what is area under the e core then? Always equals to 1, right?
1.
It is always equals to 1. Okay. By the way, this was your GATE question, GATE 2017. Find out what is your value of ET and your T mean. That was question for what kind of marks or how much marks will you consider for this question?
1 mark.
It was for 2 marks, right? 2 marks question, you need to find out what is your E curve and find out your T mean value. So this was for 1 mark and this was for 1 mark. So you got your 1 mark, right? Conversion. Okay, by the way, now, so suppose if your area under the curve is 2, then you need to divide your C curve or coordinates on C by your area, and that is basically lower value as compared to your C curve, right? Lower value as compared to C curve. So suppose if I'm drawing this. Okay, and मैं बोला गया this is your C curve, so your E curve will it be above it or will it be lower?
Lower.
Generally it is lower, right? So this will be your E curve having same shape, right? Same shape. Okay, so this is your CT curve and blue one is your ET curve as a function of time, and I am dividing this curve into these halves. First is your T1 and second is your T2. So this is first portion, this is your second portion. Above will be this and this. So area under E curve is equals to 1. Area under E curve is equals to 1. Now what is this? This red color here, this red area is showing you. This is your fraction. Are you getting the area which I draw? This is your area. What do you call that? That will be your fraction of tracer. Anyone?
Fraction tracer exit by the time
t, right? So it is a fraction of tracer which is spending time between 0 to t1, right? So it is your fraction of tracer spending time 0 to t, zero time inside your reactor. That means this can be also called as your fraction younger than T1, right? Fraction younger than T1. T1 ke pehle aa raha, right? Okay. And what is this? This second area? This one? This is your fraction of material spending time from T2 to your infinite, and what I'll call it as, that is your fraction
elder than
T2. It is elder than T2. Please write. Okay, so this is your, okay, this was about your fractions. Then suppose from 0 to T1, ET into DT, if you are considering, first will be right. I need to find out area under the curve then. This is your first value, then you will integrate from t1 to t2 ut dt. Third portion will be your t2 to infinite ut dt, and this is equals to your 0 to infinite ut dt is equals to 1. Okay. Suppose this value is your 0.5, this value is your 0.2, this value is your 0.3. What it represents actually? This whole value, whole integration. Anyone? Rutuja, would you like to try?
Sir, by the time T1, half of the treasure amount is existed.
Yes, exactly, right? So, what I'll say, 50% of material, 50% of tracer, right, has spent time lower than T1. 50% of tracer has already come out. Okay, this was. Now, this was about your basic concepts. You know what is your E core, C core, and all. Then I'll tell you moment of RTD, nth moment of RTD. Nth moment of, this is a bit of mathematics, nth moment of RTD. Okay, I'll write formula for that. Suppose if you are calculating your nth moment of RTD about your, I'll write first this. Okay, M, right? You can write M, M N. Okay, nth moment of RTD about your mean, about your mean time or any time. Okay, so this is your 0 to infinity, your T to the power N minus your T naught into your ET into DT. E kar ko just, we are multiplying by this factor. Okay, this is your nth moment of RTD, nth moment of RTD. Nth moment of RTD, okay, nth moment of RTD. About T naught, right? This is your nth moment of RTD about T naught. Now, whenever I'm writing this as 0th moment of RTD, 0th moment of RTD about origin. So whenever I'm writing origin, this M becomes your U. Okay, M becomes your U whenever I'm writing about origin. And origin mein kya hoga? Your T naught will be 0. T naught is considering to be 0 because it is origin. So can you please write down what is 0th moment of RTD about origin?
1.
That is your?
Minus 1.
1, right? So your U naught is equals to your T to the power 0 put kar denge, ye bhi 0 ho jayega. So you'll be having area under E core. 0 to infinite ET dt, and that is equals to your 1. I'll write here T to the power 0. Then please find out what is your second moment, first moment of RTD about your origin. First moment about origin. First moment about origin. So you'll be having T to the power 1, and about origin, then it is U naught, or I'll say it is U1 is your integration 0 to infinite, then T to the power 1 ET DT. I'll write exact definition here. Please correct it. This is your divided by integration 0 to infinite ET DT. This is your definition. But you know what is your area under the E core, and that is equals to 1, and that's why I wrote directly above formula, right? So here it is your divided by integration 0 to infinity et dt. And next definition will be your u1 is equals to 0 to infinite t. Yeah, happy it is. Instead of et, I'll write ct. So for nth moment, we'll be having t to the power n ct dt divided by integration 0 to infinite ct dt. This alternate definition, you can use any based on your curve, what and all curve is given. But generally we are preferring this because this value becomes 1 at the end. That's why your first moment of RTD is equals to this. And what this is suggesting you, this is your T mean, that is your mean residence time. It is giving you mean residence time. Now you do, if you know what is mean residence time, I'll tell mean residence time. Suppose this is your RTD. This is your E curve, similar to your C curve. So this is what your distribution, right? Different time B, you are having distribution. So what is mean of this? How can you calculate mean? Mean time. Anyone? If I want to calculate mean, what I'll do, I'll divide this area, whole area, into two parts in such a way that this will be your 50% of area, this will be your 50% of area. And this straight line where it divides, that is your mean residence time. This is your mean residence time. Are you getting? This range is basically your residence time, and you are getting different residence time. But what is your mean? Mean residence time is basically time which divides your area into your two equal halves, right? Area under the curve into your two equal halves. Or I can say this is your mean of all values, mean of all values, and you are calculating using your area under the curve, right? Kaise aaye? Because different time ke you have molecules, alag alag time pe you are getting your molecules of tracer. उसका कुछ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन होगा. सो वी डोंट नीड टू जस्ट कंसिडर योर एवरेज ऑफ दिस टाइम, वी नीड टू कंसिडर नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स आल्सो, राइट? नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स आर ए सपोज योर मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल, आई टोल्ड यू इन यस्टरडेज एग्जांपल, सपोज फॉर बी टेक आई टोल्ड योर मेन रेजिडेंस टाइम इज योर 4 years, राइट? बिकॉज मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स पासिंग ईयर, ओके, मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स कंप्लीटिंग इन 4 years, दैट वाज योर मेन रेजिडेंस टाइम इज 4. यहाँ पे यू हैव ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड 90% of students completing in 4 years, plus your 2% completing your 5 years, then your 1% completing in your first year only. So this will be accordingly, okay? So we need to consider what is concentration and what is your time, both factors, right? So yahan pe you can see this is your mean residence time. So whenever you are writing, whenever you are calculating your first moment about origin, that will be your mean residence time. That is giving you mean residence time. I hope you are clear. Please raise your hand. Okay. Next will be 0 ho gaya, first ho gaya. Now whenever I'm writing second moment of RTD about, I'm writing about your mean residence time. About mean residence time. So what is that then? That will be your M2, not U2, right? Because it is not about origin. M2. What is that M2? 0 to infinite T minus T about mean residence time. And you know what is mean residence time? We calculated just before this. T mean whole square, right? Because it is second moment. Please correct this. This will be your T minus T naught to the power n. T minus T naught to the power n. So you'll be having T minus T mean to the power 2 because second moment into your ET dt. And it is divided by your ET dt. So I'll not consider that because it is equals to 1. So what you are getting here? I'm just writing simple. What is physical significance of that? You please solve this. So it is your sigma T square and it is called as variance. Variance. And what do you mean by variance? Variance is basically your, what it is telling you, occur. Anyone?
Consistency.
What consistency? Okay. So I'll write here. This variance is giving you spreadness of your curve. Spreadness of your curve. All right. Spreadness of curve. Suppose you are having two curves. This is one. This is second. And both are ET curves. This is your first curve and this is your second curve. Continued. Okay. So can you guess which one will be having more variance? The one which has been spread over more distance or longer distance. So your first will be having low variance or low spreadness. Low spreadness. Low variance. And yahan pe kya hoga, in second you will be having, this has been spread over long time, you will be having high spreadness. That is your high variance. Can you guys solve this equation? Please expand it and then multiply individually. You will be having m2 is equals to your integration 0 to infinity. You will be having t square et dt minus your 2 minus, yes it is minus, minus of integration 0 to infinity t into t mean et dt. Plus you will be having 0 to infinity t mean square et dt, right? What I did? Just expanded a minus b whole square. Now what is your m2? What is this? T square et dt.
U2.
Nth moment with respect to origin.
Right, so it is your second moment with respect to origin. So it is U2 minus of 2 T mean. And suppose I'm taking out this common here. So what is this? T into ET dt. That is your T mean, right?
T mean.
My this then plus you are having T square, T mean square, right? T mean square. And what is this? Then area under E curve, that is equals to 1. So what you are getting here is M2 is equals to your U2 minus T mean square. Right? And this value is equals to your variance. This is giving you variance, how your curve has spread over your time zone, right? Sigma T square. And maybe you know what is your standard deviation then. Standard deviation will be your square root of variance. square root of variance. So it is square root of your sigma t square. This is a basic definition you must know. Standard deviation. This is your m2. Can you guys please tell me what is your variance of ideal PFR?
Zero.
Why?
Because the distribution curve is a straight line.
It is parallel
to y-axis.
Yes. So variance of your ideal PFR is equals to zero. That means there is no spreadness. Tumhara curve in here, you don't have altitude. Your spreadness is equals to zero. That is no spreadness. So your sigma t square is equals to zero. Right, your spreadness of your ideal PFR is equals to zero. Now you know what is the significance of your sigma t square. That is telling you your spreadness of curve. So suppose कुछ भी condition में suppose तुमने consider किया एक tracer डाल दिया. You have a reactor, lab के reactor पकड़ लो तुम. और in CRE 2 lab you will be having this experiment जहाँ पे you will be putting a small amount of tracer. Okay. Tracer तुम put करोगे, you are determining your concentration at different time, right? This is your practical, this is your experiment in your next semester. जहाँ पे you will be determining concentration of tracer at different time. उसके बाद you will calculate your sigma t square. And अगर ये zero आ गया, तो what will be your observation? That is your PFR and the PFR is your ideal. Such kind of observations were there. So when we move deeper in this CRE2 non-ideal reactor portion, so we'll be having idea ki what kind of reactor it is, what kind of non-ideal is there and all. Okay, so this was about your variance. Now for the definition I'll write third moment of RTD about your mean residence time. You write mean residence time. That is your M3 is equals to your integration 0 to infinite T minus T mean cube ET into DT. I'll write what is its physical significance. This is giving you skewness. Skewness of curve. And what do you mean by skewness? It is giving you spreadness of curve in particular direction. Is direction mein it is spreading or it is more about that measure of your curve in particular direction. Spreadness of curve in particular direction. Now I'll take some examples. Please. This is your curve. All your E curves, right? So you know what is on X axis and what is on Y axis. You have divided 50%, 50%. This is your T mean, right? And then next curve will be your So first square represents what? It is your positively skewed. This is your value, and dusri value is your maximum value. That is peak value kahan pe aa rahi hai? Yahan pe aa rahi hai. So this is your mean value. And this is your maximum value, T max I can write. Means maximum number of molecules having this residence time. So here it is T mean, and your T max will be this. Kya ho raha hai yahan pe? First is your T max pehle hi aa raha hai, right? T max pehle hi aa raha hai. So it is your more variation in time after your this T mean. क्या हो सकता है? So ये पहले आ रहा है your T mean, so it is your negatively skewed. This T mean is coming after, so it is your positively skewed. Positively skewed, and this is your equally skewed. T max भी उधर ही आ रहा है, so you will be having equally skewed. This is just for your information. Skewness, what is the significance? Equally skewed, positively skewed, because your T max incoming, T max is here, and your T min is after your T max, right? बाद में आ रहा है, तो मोस्ट ऑफ द फ्रैक्शन इज कमिंग आफ्टर हियर. यू कैन सी लॉन्ग टेल इज देयर, लॉन्ग टेल इज देयर. सो इट इज योर पॉजिटिवली स्क्यूड, एंड हियर पहले ही आ रहा है. दैट मींस योर टी जो मीन था पहले ही आ रहा है, सो इट इज योर नेगेटिव स्क्यूड. आई होप यू आर क्लियर विद दिस. Just after looking at your curve, you can find out if it is positively skewed or negatively skewed or equally skewed. Okay. Generally, we are studying up to your second moment of RDT in our syllabus. Okay. This is for your higher studies. Now, you know what is your E curve? What is your C curve? You know. Why there is need of dimensionless number? In order to have your scalable property, scalability. I'll explain it after your completion of this portion, this non-ideal reactor, why I am using this dimensionless number and how it is important. Okay, when we'll take examples. So यहाँ पे हम कुछ नहीं करने वाले. You are having your E curve or your any curve, you can say C curve है, or your E curve with respect to time, with respect to your time. What I'm actually doing here is this is your curve and this is your T mean. सभी time को, each and every time I'm just dividing by T mean. Curve will be like here it is. Suppose T1, this is your T2, T3, and all. So you will be having curve like this, and this is your T1 divided by T mean. This is your T2 divided by T mean. This will be your one, right? Then you will be having T3 divided by T mean. क्या किया है मैंने? Just divide किया each and every time को by T mean, right? By T mean. Okay. अभी मुझे बताओ, in order to have balance, यहाँ पे मैंने divide किया. What is your area here? ET into DT integration करेंगे, right? अभी यहाँ पे मैंने divide कर लिया, so I'll multiply here by T mean, right? जो भी मेरे ET की वैल्यू है इसे मैं T min से मल्टीप्लाई करूंगा, तो व्हाट इज योर एरिया हियर, ET इनटू T min इनटू T डिवाइड बाय T min, सो विल यू गेट सेम राइट एरिया अंडर ईकर दैट इज इक्वल्स टू 1, हियर एरिया अंडर द ईकर दैट इज इक्वल्स टू 1. This I got. Then, so whenever I'm dividing this anytime by t mean, that is your theta. Theta is your dimensionless time. That is your t divided by t mean is equals to your theta. That is equals to your dimensionless time. I'll tell you what is its important, okay? What is its significance at the end? And at that time you'll realize, yes, it was important. Compare your different reactors. Okay? So this is your dimensionless time, and I'll write the topic here. Normalized RTD function. Normalized RTD function. These terms are new to you, but if you revise, this will be in what I'll say in behavioral change you will be having here. So you will be comfortable with this. Okay. So this is your tau. This is your S. Okay. So you know what is your tau. Tau is your space time. And S is your space velocity, right? This is your concept. So your space time is what? Kiran?
Volume of reactor divided by the volumetric flow rate at the entry.
Right, so at the entry, so it is your volume of reactor divided by your volumetric flow rate initially at the reactor inlet condition. So it does not care about what is happening inside reactor. Inside reactor. Okay. And what is your T min then? The space velocity is your inverse of your tau. Inverse of tau, and then you will be having T min. I told you T min is volume of reactor divided by your average volumetric flow rate. That is your T min, and T min, this T min is same as of whatever T min you calculated using your moment of RTD, right? That is your first moment of RTD about your origin. U1, right? U1 is equal to T min. So T min कैसे calculate करते हैं? Using your RTD. Right? अभी मुझे बताओ, suppose if epsilon is greater than 0, so what is your condition? T min or tau की? Epsilon is your fractional change in volume. Just by observing, क्या रहेगा? Epsilon is greater than 0.
Tau is greater than T min.
Tau is greater than your T min. This means epsilon is greater than 0. तुम्हारा expansion हुआ है. That means जो भी तुम्हारा actual time रहेगा, that will be your less, because तुम्हारा जब pressure बढ़ेगा, तुम्हारा volume बढ़ेगा, pressure बढ़ेगा, तो your velocity will increase and molecule will come earlier. And here it is T min greater than tau. I have cleared you already this. So now just I am replacing everything in terms of theta. T divided by T min is your theta. Okay, so what is your dt? T min into d theta. Right? Then what is your ET into DT? This is your fraction of material. between time t and t plus dt. So what is that value then in terms of e theta? dt ko replace karo, you will be having et t min d theta, and this is your dimensionless value, that is your e theta into d theta. So your et into dt is equals to your e theta into d theta. This is important. I'm clearing this mathematical portion. This will be very helpful while defining your normalities in CSTR, PFR, that will start in next class, but just I'm clearing this before. Right, et into dt is equals to your e theta into d theta. Are you getting what is your dimensionless time and what is your normalized RTD? Whenever I am writing this in terms of your et dt, it is your e curve, and whenever I am converting this e curve into your e theta wala curve, we will be having e theta into d theta here. So theta will be there. So this is your normalized RTD, normalized RTD function. Normalized RTD function. The moment of RTD which we calculate for normal, generalized RTD, it will be similar to your normalized RTD. So what is your theta mean then? You know what is your t mean? Integration t into et dt, right? This is your t mean value, mean residence time. So what is your theta mean? Mean of your dimensionless time. This is 0 to infinite theta e theta d theta. Are you clear with this? Mean or average dimensionless time. जो भी तुम्हारा थीटा था, that was your divided by time, उस वैल्यू का मीन. So यहाँ से the graph which I drawn earlier, what is your theta mean here? These values are your theta values, right? On x-axis you are having theta value. तो theta का mean क्या रहेगा?
One,
right? That is equals to your one. So your theta mean is equals to your one. Okay, theta mean is your one. So dimensionless time जो भी था, उसका mean is your one. यहाँ पे क्या रहेगा? Value is lower than one, right? यहाँ पे it is greater than one. Greater than one, right? Greater than one. This is your value one. Now, this also can be proved. कैसे? This is your equation. This is your theta mean is equals to your zero to infinite. What is your theta? T divided by t mean into your et. What is your e theta? E theta is basically et into t mean. Right? यही किया था मैंने, यहाँ पे डिवाइड किया था t divided by t mean. तो यहाँ पे et को क्या करूँगा? I'll multiply by t mean. And what is your d theta? That is your dt divided by t mean. And you know what is, if your time is zero, theta is your zero. If your time is infinite, your theta is your infinite. So you will be having theta mean is equal to zero to infinite, one by t mean, t into et dt. Right? And what is this value? Integration of this value. T mean, right? So it is it same? Theta mean is equals to your 1. Theta mean is equals to your 1. So this was about your mathematical portion, and there is a lot of mathematics involved in next definitions. We will see your cumulative RTT function. This was about your normalized RTT function. And when you are comfortable with this, we'll start with your step tracer injection and how we'll apply this over different your reactor. Okay. So please let me know, are you clear with this topic up to this? If there is any doubt, mathematical portion hai thoda, and this is your first time, so are you clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Right. ओके तो तुम्हें पता चल गया था व्हाट इज योर सिग्मा टी स्क्वायर, राइट? सिग्मा टी स्क्वायर. आई एम प्लानिंग टू कंप्लीट मैथमेटिक्स बाय टुडे एंड इन नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट विद आवर रिएक्टर्स. डायरेक्टली वी विल स्टार्ट आवर रिएक्टर्स. तो व्हाट इज योर सिग्मा टी स्क्वायर? दैट इज योर वेरियंस, राइट? सो अभी हमने क्या किया था, we first calculated t mean, then we found t mean sigma t square, that is your variance, and uske baad kya calculate kiya tha, we calculated skewness, right? Variance and then skewness, yahan tak pahunche the hum, right? Now this is your variance. T mean ki jagah we calculated theta mean. Abhi sigma t square ki jagah kya calculate karenge? कैलकुलेट सिग्मा थीटा स्क्वायर. सिग्मा थीटा स्क्वायर, राइट? तो व्हाट इज योर डेफिनेशन ऑफ सिग्मा टी स्क्वायर? Anyone?
0 to infinity t minus t power whole square et dt,
right? Et into dt. So can you guys please convert this into sigma theta square? This will be your 0 to infinity theta minus, what is your theta mean then? Here it will be theta mean, right? Then e theta d theta, right? Your theta mean is equals to 1. Theta mean is equals to your 1. If you expand, you will get relation between sigma t square and sigma theta square. Okay, I'll write sigma theta square is equals to your sigma t square divided by t mean का होल स्क्वायर. When you enter in your class, no, during your CRE2, you will directly told these values. Nobody will explain you what is your cumulative, what is your normalized and all. They will directly write sigma theta, sigma t, your t mean, your relation between sigma theta square and sigma t square, right? I'm just deriving here how actually these formulas were, right? So you will be having an upper hand over there when theory 2 will start. Okay, so sigma theta square, that is your theta minus theta mean ka square e theta d theta, right? Now if you substitute here 1 and expand it, what will you get? Sigma theta square is equals to integration 0 to infinite t divided by t mean whole square et t mean in place of this I'm writing and d theta is your dt divided by t mean is t mean right.
Sir, it's theta minus 1 whole square. So theta square plus 1 square.
Yeah, it is theta. Theta minus 1 whole square. Yes, it is exactly that value. So you will be having first value ka square. Then theta min is your 1. So, okay, okay. How can we expand this?
Sir, like we can make theta square plus 1 square minus 2 theta and theta is okay. T by T bar.
Yes,
we can
yes.
Individually divide terms on this.
Okay, so we'll do that. Okay, first you will be having your sigma theta square is equals to your integration 0 to infinite. This will be your theta square minus 2 theta minus 1, or just plus 1, e theta d theta, right? So 0 to infinite theta square e theta d theta minus 2 into integration this theta into e theta d theta plus your integration of e theta d theta. Can you guys please calculate values? Minus this is 2 times you'll get theta mean minus this is your 1 this is your 1 so this value will be your theta mean is 1 right you'll be having minus 1 integration 0 to infinite theta square e theta d theta minus 1 are you guys getting this
yes sir
right now यहाँ पे क्या होगा इसको हम कन्वर्ट करेंगे यहाँ पे लिख रहा हूँ मैं थीटा स्क्वायर इज टी माइनस टी मीन का स्क्वायर ई थीटा इज योर ई टी इंटू टी मीन एंड योर डी थीटा इज योर डी टी डिवाइड बाय टी मीन एंड इट इज माइनस वन दिस इज योर इक्वेशन नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू t mean will cancel sigma theta square is equals to your 1 by t mean square equation 0 to infinite t square et dt this will be your 1 value and second will be your minus of 1 right you will get sigma theta square is equals to 1 by t mean square what is this u2 then what remains minus 1 et dt that is separately another term okay this will be your minus 1 so you will be having u2 minus t mean square divided by your t mean square right what is your u2 minus t mean square second moment of rtd about your mean residence time. So it is your m2 divided by t mean square. And now I'm substituting your m2. So you will get sigma theta square is equal to sigma t square divided by t mean square. This is very important. Please be careful. गेट में पूछा गया था, इट वॉज आस्क्ड इन गेट, नॉट एग्जैक्टली द फार्मूला, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस फार्मूला वॉज आस्क्ड, एंड दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट व्हाइल वी व्हेन यू स्टार्ट स्टडिंग योर टैंकिंग सीरीज मॉडल. नेक्स्ट पोर्शन विल बी दैट इन अपकमिंग क्लासेस, तो दिस विल बी इम्पोर्टेंट. सिग्मा थीटा स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू योर सिग्मा टी स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय टी मीन स्क्वायर, राइट? दिस इज, सो यू कैन राइट वेरियंस divided by t mean ka square, that is your sigma theta square. Now for ideal PFR, what is your sigma theta square? This is zero, right? There is no normalized sigma theta square. For sigma t square is also equals to zero. Match the pair में आता है ये, match the pair. Ideal PFR, sigma theta square is equals to zero. Now, one last topic for today's class, cumulative RTD function. This is the last mathematical portion, cumulative RTD function. So you know what is your ET curve, right? This is your ET curve. I am dividing it into different parts. Okay. This is your T1, T2 and T3. First area, second area, this is your third area. Now, suppose this is your A1, ये A2 है, and this is your A3. So what is your A1, A2 and A3? Fraction of tracer from 0 to T1. Second is your fraction of tracer coming out at exit of reactor, you must write, from T1 to T2. Third one is your fraction of tracer from T2 to T3, right? Okay. Now, if I'm asking you, what is your tracer up to T2? Fraction of tracer up to T2. That is
A1 plus A2.
A1 plus A2, correct. Up to T3, A1 plus A2 plus A3, right? What I am writing here is, generalize is fraction of tracer up to any time T, fraction of tracer up to any time T, right? That means I am integrating ET curve up to what? Up to T.
T.
Right? And this is called as your cumulative RTD function, that is your F of T. Cumulative RTD function. So whenever I'm saying it is up to T2, what an all fraction has come, I'll sum it over up to T2. Right? So suppose if I want to convert this E curve into your F curve, so kya hoga? see, it is initially this value, then we have a cumulative, right? Like it is up to T2, that means it is adding up to T2. So we have a pehle it is value is this. Again, isme kuch add ho raha hai, right? Choti value thi, badi value add hogi, badh raha hai. Then uske baad value addition will be decreasing, right? I hope you are clear with the graph, right? So initially it is at lower value. It started increasing up to maximum value. This is your maximum, and then addition will decrease, right? That whatever amount is added up to that time, it is decreasing. So your overall value will decrease and it will reach to this point. And what is this maximum value then? This maximum value is
one,
right? It is one. So this is your f of t curve versus your time. This is your last portion, right? Just I'm accumulating it. Just I'm adding up to that time. Okay. Now suppose if I am giving you f of t curve, can you please convert into your et curve? Kaise hoga? Because you know integration et is equal to f of t. So what is your dft divided by dt? That is your et curve. So what I'm just doing here is I'm just taking slopes at different time of what curve? F curve. So this is my f curve. I'll take slope at different time, right? This is your time. First slope, it is your this value. First it is zero, then it has increased slope kaise ho raha, increase ho raha, right? Increase, final decrease, then zero, right? So pehle kya tha, it is zero, it has started increasing, it has reached to this maximum value, maximum slope, then it has started decreasing. So are you getting your e curve then back, right? It is similar to your e curve. So this is your et curve. So you will be having relations. This one is first, this is your second. So whenever I'm taking slope of f curve at different time, I'll get your et curve. And et curve ko if I'm accumulating it, I'm accumulating it up to that time, then you will be having your cumulative distribution function, that is your f of t. Your f of t. So whenever I'm taking it is dft by dt is your f2 minus f1 divided by your t2 minus t1, that is your slope, right? So kya kar raha hu main actual mein, what and all my value is there, usse main initial value is subtracting. I'm subtracting your previous value from your this value. And opposite kya hota hai, whenever I'm drawing your f of t curve, I'm adding previous wala values, right? So if I'm subtracting it, I'll get lower value. So this is your et curve and that is your ft curve. I hope I'm clear with this. It is a slope and that is your accumulation. So be careful while writing your f of t is integration 0 to t et dt. This is very important. Generally, people do mistake here, because integration 0 to infinity is your et area and that is equals to your 1. So finally you are getting value 1, but it is up to time t, what and all concentration you are getting, you will sum it over, right? Jaise tumne initially 5 moles dale the, and at time t1 you are getting 1, at time t2 you are getting 2, at time t3 you are getting 2. So up to time 2, up to time t3, you will get sum of all. So 1 plus 2 plus 2, that is your 5. This is about your ft curve. So I hope you are clear with your et curve and ft curve. Anyone would like to add anything here? Any doubt? Can you please explain me what you studied today with brief information about that? Saikiran, Kaushik.
So like first today we got to know the relation between ET and CT, like curves, E curve and C curve.
Yes, correct.
And also later about the moments of RTD and its significance, like first moment is mean time and second moment is variance.
Yes, exactly.
And later we went into dimensionless time.
Right,
and we found out the real relations between sigma theta and sigma t theta bar.
Okay, yes.
And then cumulative distribution function.
Cumulative, just we are adding up to time t, right? Any time t, we are just adding up to that value. That is your cumulative RTD function. These are the basics of mathematics, and when will this apply? All these values will apply in your ideal CSTR, your ideal PFR, and we'll solve it for two injections. One is your step tracer injection and your pulse injection. Okay, for both we'll solve, and at that time you'll find, okay, what kind of curves you are getting and all. Like suppose I'll write here just for telling you. Suppose this is your curve, right? And RTD you are getting like this. So based on this curve only, this is your ET curve. This is your ET curve, right? You just write here, minute here, and it is minute inverse. Unit is important, okay? Unit is important. So based on this, you can guess key for what reactor you are getting this kind of curve. So I'll tell this is for your CSTR, okay? Because I know how this curve equation of this curve is, and generally what kind of curve I'm getting for such equations and curve, vice versa. So this is one curve. Then suppose if I'm getting this kind of curve, right? Ye to curve, I got this curve here exactly same, but after some time, right? It is not starting from your actual time. This is your actual t is equal to zero, but this is your time lag, and this time lag is suppose 5 minutes. So what kind of condition that might be? Okay, so such a kind of curve I can analyze. So yahan pe kya hota hai, this is your PFR, because PFR your increases your time, and it is then followed by CSTR. So based on such course, you can analyze ki, okay, this is my single CSTR curve, but actually there is no CSTR. This is actually behaving like your combination of PFR followed by your CSTR, right? Based on these curves, you can identify. So this mathematics is very important. If you understand your curves, your mathematics is strong, then you can easily predict what kind of arrangement you are having, even if your reactor is different, but that reactor may behave like a different reactor, okay? Because that is non-identity. So this was about today's class. We'll use this function in tomorrow's class. We'll solve, we'll derive, okay, and we'll analyze the curves, okay? So thank you so much for connecting here. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir.